Hello and welcome. So, I will teach you how to easily create the mist effect with some basic compositing notes. Let's do this. I assume you already have created a scene to apply the effect. The mist effect will add more depth to the scene. Notice the furthest pillars are not showing in the camera view. To correct this, select the camera, go to the camera object data tab and increase the clipping end value. As you can see, the distant pillars are visible now. Now, set the view shading mode to material. Activate the mist display for the camera. You will be able to see this line, marking the beginning and the end of the mist effect. Go to the World tab and activate mist visibility. The mist will become visible in the viewport. To set the mist further away from the camera, increase the fade-in parameter. I want the furthest pillars to be covered by thick mist. It's also possible to change the type of falloff. I prefer quadratic, but that depends on the scene. Now, I want the furthest pillars to still be visible through the thick mist so we can see their details. So, I will deactivate mist visibility. Let's add the mist through compositing nodes. Open the node editor. Go to compositing nodes. Check use nodes. Check backdrop. Now, be sure to check to see if the compositing option is checked in the post-processing menu. Let's create the node setup. But first, check the mist pass for this render layer. This mist pass will take the previously set mist parameters, such as the mist depth, into account. Now, you will have a mist output for this render layer. Add a mix node. Connect the mist output to the mix factor. Set the color values as shown here. Add another mix node and set its blending mode to add. Connect this add node as shown. This color input defines the color of the mist. As you can see, we have a very thin red mist in the horizon. With the backdrop activated, we should be able to see the viewer node results in the node editor. To do that, you need to add a viewer node. Now, we can see the changes in real time, instead of constantly rendering to see the results. The brighter this color, the thicker the mist will be. Change the mist color to create the right atmosphere for your scene. Thank you. As you can see, we can see the furthest pillars, even through the deepest area of the mist. This technique can be used to create an atmospheric sky in which you can still see the stars in the background. Anyway, like this video if it was helpful, and subscribe for more Blender tutorials, animations and random cringy videos.